Come in here, says Michael's boss. He is angry again. Michael is a cameraman and he works for SFX News. His boss, Mr. Frederick, is angry with him. It is the second time this week. Michael walks slowly into the office. He is in big trouble. Close the door, says Mr. Frederick. There is a video in his hand. This is bad, thinks Michael. He doesn't like my work. Mr. Frederick looks at Michael. Are you a news cameraman? He asks. Yes, of course, says Michael. Well, this isn't news. He throws the video at the door. I have a 3-year-old son. He can't do better. Go away and find some news. I want a film that hits me here. Mr. Frederick puts his hand on his heart. And Michael. Yes, boss. This is your last chance. Michael walks slowly out of Mr. Frederick's office. His face is red. He can't talk to me like that, he thinks. I'm a good cameraman. I'm unlucky, that's all. But I can't be angry with him because I need my job. Michael sits on his chair and looks out of the window. He sees an old man sitting in his garden. He feels tired. Am I too old for this job? Thinks Michael. Am I too tired? There is a newspaper on Michael's desk. He picks it up and reads it. There is a volcano in Hawaii. The volcano is erupting and people are leaving. Michael sees a photograph of the volcano. It looks dangerous. Maybe, he thinks. Mr. Frederick walks past. Reading the newspaper, he says, Remember, this is your last chance. Michael feels very angry, but he says nothing. This is bad, he thinks. I must go to Hawaii and make an exciting film. Michael gets in his car and quickly drives home. He has a nice car. It is fast and he loves it. It is also expensive. He needs to work. Michael stops the car next to his house. He goes in the house. What do I need? He thinks. He puts some clothes in a bag and picks it up. One more thing, he thinks. My video camera. He picks up his camera and gives it a kiss. We can do it, old friend, he says. Later that day, Michael takes a plane to Hawaii. There are only 7 people on the plane. He looks out of the window. Hawaii is beautiful, he thinks. There are big waves on the sea. I would like to go surfing, thinks Michael. Perhaps another time. But as the plane gets closer, the sky is very dark. At the airport, lots of people are running. Some people are crying. The volcano is erupting, they say to Michael. Why are you here? I'm here because I'm a news cameraman. A good news cameraman, he tells them. He can see the volcano. It is a long way away. There is black smoke and red fire. Is this a good idea? Thinks Michael. Some news people are leaving Hawaii. They are getting on a plane. Michael talks to them. A girl tells him that the volcano is very dangerous. I think my friend Jennifer is there. She wants to make a film, too. Is she alive or dead? I don't know, says the girl. You must come with us, she says. You can't go to the volcano. I want to leave the island, thinks Michael. I don't want to die, but I can't go with you. I have work to do, he says. Okay, says the girl. Look out for my friend Jennifer. She has big blue eyes. Please tell her to leave the island. Okay, says Michael. He says
goodbye
to the girl. He watches the plane leave. This really is my last chance, he thinks. Just then the volcano makes a big noise. A dog runs quickly past. An old woman starts to cry. Michael looks at her. He wants to say something, but he can't. The sun is hot, but suddenly he is cold. He is afraid. I can't be afraid, he says. He looks at his camera and says, "Let's go, old friend." Michael walks through the town. The sky is getting darker. The red fire over the volcano is getting bigger and bigger. Michael is feeling more afraid. In the town, Michael meets a man. The man is leaving with his family. How can I get to the volcano? Michael asks. Cars don't go to the volcano, says the man. The drivers are afraid. You must walk, is it far? Asks Michael. No, says the man. But the fire is hot. Take lots of water with you. There is a television in a shop window. It is not showing pictures of the volcano. I am the only news person here, Michael thinks. I have a chance to make the only film about the volcano. I must go. The road in front of him is very long. His legs feel tired, but he begins to walk. After 2 long hours, Michael is on the volcano. There is a lot of smoke and a lot of fire. Michael can't see any people. I must be quick, he thinks. Michael films the smoke and the fire. A big rock nearly hits him, but he films it. This film is good, he thinks. He is afraid but happy. How could Mr. Frederick be angry now? Michael thinks. He is taking lots of film. Another rock almost hits him. Michael feels hot and tired. It's time to go, says Michael. Good job, he says to his camera. A bigger rock goes over his head. I don't like this. I must go now, he says. Michael can smell the smoke. He can feel the fire. Michael puts his camera under his arm. He starts to run. Just then the volcano makes a noise. Michael runs faster. Suddenly, he hears a different noise. Is that a woman? Thinks Michael. It can't be. There is nobody here. He starts to run again, but then, help. It is somebody. They need me, he thinks. Hello, he says. Where are you? Michael looks everywhere, but he can't see anybody. I'm here. Please help me. Michael sees something behind a rock. It moves. He goes to the rock and sees a young woman there. She can't move her leg because it is under the rock. Oh, thank you. Thank you, she says to Michael. She begins to cry. My leg. I think it's broken. Wait a minute, says Michael. I can help. He pushes the rock. It is too big. There are small rocks in front. He pushes them away, then pushes the big rock again. It moves a little. He pushes harder. It moves a little more. Arg, cries the woman. Suddenly the rock moves down the volcano. The woman's face is white. She smiles slowly. Are you Jennifer? Michael asks. Yes, I am. She says. How do you know? It doesn't matter now. My name is Michael. I have to carry you, Jennifer. But first, Michael has a tripod. He ties it to Jennifer's leg. Does that feel better? He asks. Jennifer smiles again. Thank you, Michael, she says. She is very tired. I'm usually very careful, but not today. Come on. We have to get off the volcano, says Michael. Put your arm around me, Michael tells Jennifer. He puts down his camera. Jennifer gets up slowly. Her leg is very bad. Take it easy, Michael says. They start to walk very slowly. It's okay, he says. You're okay. Meter by meter, they move down the volcano. They are almost hit by rocks. Black smoke is in their mouths. Hot fire is close behind them. But they are alive. Michael, wait, says Jennifer suddenly. Your camera. She stops walking. Her face is black with smoke. Jennifer's blue eyes look at Michael. Michael looks back at Jennifer. You're more important than my camera, he tells her. But the volcano. I can wait here. You go back. It's not too late. Michael says nothing. They keep walking slowly down the volcano and away from Michael's camera. Jennifer is now very tired. Her leg is badly broken. Michael stops behind a big rock. Do you want some water? He asks. Michael has some water in his bag. Jennifer and Michael are both thirsty. They drink the water. Jennifer begins to go to sleep. This is dangerous. Jennifer must stay alive, Michael thinks. Don't go to sleep, Jennifer. Talk to me. Where is your home? Tell me about your family. Do you like books? They walk and Jennifer talks. When she stops talking, Michael asks another question. They are almost off the volcano. Michael looks back. Where is his camera? Is it in the fire? They are off the volcano. Michael sits down next to Jennifer. He puts his head in his hands. What's the matter? Asks Jennifer. Everything, says Michael. I have no camera and no film. Now I don't have a job. There are no more chances. Jennifer puts her arm around him. It's okay. 2 hours later, they walk into the town. People come out to see them. Are you all right? They ask Jennifer. I have a broken leg, but I am alive, she says, and looks at Michael. Thank you, Michael. He smiles. There is a helicopter waiting for you, says a man in a suit. It is leaving the island. You must get on quickly. The man helps them into the helicopter. In the helicopter, a man says to Michael, "Do you need anything?" "My camera," he says. "But it is on the volcano." "My camera is my best friend and oldest friend." Michael closes his eyes and goes to sleep. Michael is now at home. He does not want to see his boss, Mr. Frederick. Then one morning he hears the telephone. "Hello," he says. "This is Mr. Frederick. You must come to work tomorrow. I need to talk to you."
"Goodbye."
The next day, Michael goes to work. His friends are happy to see him. "Well done, Michael," they say. "Thanks," says Michael. He is happy to see his friends, but he is afraid of Mr. Frederick. His boss sees him. "You, get in here." "This is it," thinks Michael. In the office, Mr. Frederick looks at Michael. He has something in his hands. "Do you remember the people in the helicopter?" he asks. "Yes," says Michael. "They remember you. I think you need to thank them." He moves his hands. There is Michael's camera. "My camera," says Michael. "The camera is broken," says Mr. Frederick, "but we have the film and it's very good." He smiles. "My old friend," says Michael to his camera. He gives it a kiss. "Let's watch your video," Mr. Frederick says. They watch the film on the TV. They can see Michael and Jennifer. Michael moves the big rock. He helps Jennifer to walk. Big rocks are falling out of the sky. The volcano makes a noise. The fire is red and the smoke is black. It is very exciting. Next time, remember to turn it off. Or maybe not, says Mr. Frederick. This video hits me right here. Then Mr. Frederick says, "Oh, and Michael, we have a new news person." Jennifer comes into the room. She isn't black with smoke now. She smiles at Michael. She's beautiful, Michael thinks. She hits me right here.